Hola Mis Bonitas, so you'll see this outfit, this hair, this lack of makeup for at least one other video. But this is my trash for the month of, what is it? Month of May and the month of June, because I did not upload my May one, so I figured I was kind of combine both of them into it. So I will have my total list below of how much that I spent in the month of May, how much I used up in the month of May, and as well as how much I used up in the month of June, how much I spent in the month of June, because I did spend some money both those months. And then I'll have my running total for the year to date also down there. The reason why is I don't have all those numbers in front of me right now, but I really want to do this video and get my trash out of the way. So before I get into it, I do have a declutter, and it's actually from the month of June. I have four items. So this Stila Smudge Stick Waterproof Eyeliner in the color Midnight Blue. I lost the lid, and it is dried out completely, and I'm really bummed about it because I was enjoying it while I did use it. But yeah, so I tried kind of breaking it and seeing if there was better. No, not working out. So that's going to go. And then four products is actually some lipsticks. I've been kind of going through my makeup off camera, obviously, because I'm trying to condense it down to where I will no longer have any of my makeup stuff actually in the baby's room, because right now I have one drawer where I have everything right now. Well, three tier, but it's all kind of shared in her room, and I do need to get all this stuff eventually out, especially when she starts moving a lot more, i.e. crawling. So I did go through recently and kind of been selling some makeup, rehoming it, or throwing it away, decluttering it if it's old. These four items are actually old. The kind of smell has changed, which is interesting because one of them is only just a little over a year old. And this is the Essence matte lipstick number 2. This was like one of my favorites from Essence, but the actual like scent has changed. And the biggest thing too is all of these, it is pretty warm in my house and it's pretty warm in this room, but these are the particular lipsticks of the bullet ones that I do have left that started to actually melt. So it kind of looks like this. It just looks funky, and when things are warm, they can just not be so good. So I'm letting them go. And then the three others are from Milani. This is Femme Rose, Plum Rose, and Rose Hip. This was a wonderful hot pink lipstick. Again, it's sweating, so it doesn't work out so well. And these still smell like vanilla, but they just kind of, I don't really trust with how this heat has been, of it changing and the actual like integrity of the lipstick for mold or anything like that. So it's okay. These particular ones are older in my collection. These are like at least 2 years old, so it's okay. They go. So that rambled on for like 3 minutes of getting rid of five things, but continuing on. So this is actually going to be for going backwards. So this is the trash for the month of June. I do have more samples than anything else. So let's get those out of the way. I have a Bare Minerals Brilliant Future Age Defense and Renew Serum. And then I have the Skin Longevity, the Vital Power Infusion. So this was the first one that they had, and then they kind of made a more focused one for like more mature skin, like trying to get like the age rewinding one. And really, I think I felt my skin tighten a little bit more with this one. And this is like the third bottle of this I've used of sample size. So no matter what, I do really enjoy skincare, and I really enjoy Bare Minerals skincare. Another sample product. So a couple of these were in this like Ulta beauty box that I purchased right before I actually had my daughter. And so I kind of threw it all into my bag for the hospital, and I used some of it, and then some of it I didn't use or didn't get used while I was in the hospital. So I've been using them up as I go. So one of them is a L'Oreal Pure Sugar Scrub, a smooth and glow. So this was like a mini to try it out, and it's okay. I have better scrubs for like my face. I believe it was supposed to be for your face, so it just didn't really have as much scrub as I like, so I didn't feel like my face really got clean with it, but it was okay. I would not repurchase a full size though. This is the La Roche-Posay. It is a moisturizer. It's a moisturizer. And it was pretty good. I did use this when I was in the hospital, and then I also, like, I stopped using it, and then I decided to use it up in June, so that's kind of how that works out. Olay makeup remover. They were like seven like makeup wipes, and this was also in that like bundle from Ulta, so I used those up. I know it seems really weird that I finished them up in June versus like I had my daughter in March, but it just kind of worked out to where I really didn't wear makeup for quite a bit of the time frame that I've been home. Something that I did finish up is the Body Shop's Tea Tree Mattifying Toner. Like that, repurchased it. I finished up. This was in my drop 10 before summer, which I never did a finale for. I did finish up quite a few products, and this is one of them that was in it. This was head toner, so this is actually like from the DNKY's like Be Delicious scent. So I definitely like that. Finish it off. Yay for that. Since I'm kind of stuck in that products I ever like did finish off but did not show, I did finish up both my body wash as well as my body lotion from Bath and Body Works and Energy, and those were that was in that project as well. And I think that's it for stuff that I finished up in June from that project. This is Bath and Body Works Pretty as a Peach body cream, and then I have a sample perfume. This actually was from Sephora, and this was the Kat Von D Saint, because that is one of my favorite like scents to get samples of. This I finished off rather quickly. This is the Wet n Wild Rose Toner, the Photo Focus one, from their Rebel Rose collection. And the reason why I started like really working on my Wet n Wild products is because they aren't technically that came out in like the middle of end of May, was that they aren't necessarily cruelty free. So I wanted to use the products up. So this is one of them, which is funny because that was semi new into my collection. And then I have some sheet masks, which I should sheet mask more, I just haven't recently. I have a unicorn mask that was for purifying. I had a detoxifying charcoal sheet mask from Yes to Tomatoes. I had a lot of Tony Moly masks that I purchased. I got them for Mother's Day, and so I've been kind of using them randomly. This is the Hydrating I'm Lavender, and then this is the Nourishing I'm Honey. I also did use a nose strip from FPL. So that was all my products in the month of June. So these are the things that happened in May. In May, I did more sheet masks. So I'll show you those. This is the Tony Moly I'm Red Wine. That's Pore Care. This is the from the Victoria's Secret Pink Collection. This is the Aloe Hydrating Mask. This was actually really nice. If you ever see them on sale at Victoria's Secret, I definitely recommend to grab some. Brightening, I'm Real Lemon Mask from Tony Moly. I did an actual like foot peel mask, and yeah, that's that. This is the rose version of that hydrogel mask. I have some more makeup wipes. This is one of my faves, and this is same sign as my man, and that is the Virgo Chic Mask. I had a sample of the Clinique ID Hydrating Jelly. This was kind of weird. I would not purchase that. As I told you, I've used quite a few samples from Bare Minerals of the Skin Longevity, so that's another one of them. This was in a replacement in my drop 10 for summer. This is the Shiseido Ibuki Eye Correct, like the eye cream. I used that up. I also used up my Wonder Firm Neck Firming and Lifting Cream. And that was, I believe, I rolled that back into another project, which I haven't done an update on recently. I've been really like bad for all my projects. And then I also, the Professional by Benefits, the Pearl Primer. So those are all, that's all my trash for the month of May and June. As you can see, it was more like samples because I was been traveling, kind of going back and forth between my parents and my house. So smaller bottles, it's easier to move around. And I've been trying to do sheet masks as well. So yeah, So I again will have totals for May and June listed below for what I spent, what I put out, as well as my actual total for the whole year to date as well. I'm hoping to get back on track with my videos. I might just have to kind of juggle a little bit better of my time in the evenings in particular. But right now I've actually, just a little quick update, I've actually been doing an online class, and so we are in week 5 right now. There are 6 weeks, and so it's pretty intense. Obviously a whole semester into 6 weeks, pretty much. I do homework every night, minus like tonight I'm filming instead and kind of playing and my stuff here at home. But normally I do schoolwork after the baby goes to bed. I have like a paper, there's quizzes every week, at least two. I had like a midterm, a paper, and a bunch of stuff all at the same time when we did our like reception, because I am officially married, and so yay for that. But if you guys want to know more about that, let me know in the comments below for anybody who's actually watching. So I'm gonna stop here, let you guys enjoy the rest of your night, day, whatever time that is for you that you are watching this, if you're watching this. And until next time, I'll be talking to you very soon. Besos. Bye.